J'ai pas fait semblant, je te jure. J'ai jamais dit non. J'ai juste. J'ai pas fait semblant, je te jure. J'ai jamais dit non. J'ai juste laissé le temps courir.
Et à ta gala, ciao.
Venir mourir.
By your sweet, 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 sweetest Princess Silk. This is Hawaii. Hawaii is composed of many islands. And I have been to the large or the big island. You can see it down below, or called also the Kona Island. On vacation, we traveled the entire island. We had a hotel, it's a timeshare, in the south. I can also call it by clock. Do you speak clock? At 6 o'clock, so to speak. Now, as I record, I cannot see it. Maybe it's 7. And, well, Kona, where the airport is at 9 o'clock. The only larger city besides Kona is Ilo, and that is at 3 o'clock. Very modern. I wouldn't say city, though. So small. There are special places where you can see a crater, you can see fern forest, and you can also see the volcano. The volcano is at four o'clock. And when you think Hawaii, you think perhaps tourist zones, like amazing resorts and luxurious lodging. Well, there are a few of those, but those are all located at 11 o'clock. Right in front of the heliport, when you want to take a helicopter and have a tour, which are quite impressive. They offer different tours, but the one we took was where the canyons are. It's so impressive. They also offer you luau, and that is also located at 11 o'clock. 10, 11 o'clock. That is the only place where you can see like luxurious resorts. We took one of those for like, I don't know, a few nights in addition, just to get to know. Otherwise, Hawaii is pretty deserted. This is the large island or the big island of Hawaii. Hawaii has endless amount of black sand landscape. Yeah, where in Germany would be cows grazing on green, wet grass. In Hawaii you have rocks and black lava sand. Large landscapes, kind of lost in space. Maybe they filmed the moon footage in Hawaii and turned a nightlight on. It's not nice. Although they advertise that there is a black sand beach. What is black sand? It's lava. No, I went. Of course I went. It's strange. It is not very inviting. It's difficult to reach. We had to rent a car. What was it again? Some car which could go on open land. Is it called 4x4 now? Yes, I'm sort of type of jeep. We did rent the car arriving to the Kona airport. And we had it all the time. We traveled the entire island. There is a park which is advertised as a nature park. We arrived. No, I think it was the middle of the week. Well, it was closed. No, it was just the middle of the day. One time we went all around the island. We hit a few pockets individually on days. But one time we did the entire thing around with the car. It's not very far. just to get to know. The luau, it's a tourist attraction. They do barbacoa, but that's in Hawaii they use pig for it. And then they have a stage, and on stage they have the typical Hawaiian outfits, and they do dances. There are male people who do dances with fire, and women dances. And then it's like large tables, like at the German beer garden, which I also don't like. And they serve you food. It's very, very expensive. But how could you miss it if you go one time to Hawaii? If that's the thing, the ideal of the Hawaiian national situation. And they do invite you when you go to the luau, because it takes a few hours. They invite you to study the dance, which is very simple. They're instructors, so small groups are formed, and that show you how to dance the Hawaiian dance and what it means. And when the stage happens, they invite you also to stay there and dance for the audience. No, in a group. I've done it, of course. I like to dance. I'm a dancer. Why wouldn't I not take the opportunity? And next to that luau, there were like, I might say hotel rooms or bungalows, but it was more like a chosa, more like a bamboo-made little things which were up above the ground on a sand pathway. It looked very simple, very romantic walking through there, though. Yeah, what isn't romantic at nighttime with, you know, real firelight or tiki lights or any light, which is authentic, pretty. There are a few beaches. For example, there is a beach where you can see there is no coral reefs. That's a Cancun. But you can see like colorful fishes. One fish bit me, or who did the fish bite? I don't know. Weird, tiny little thing, man. Very small. There's plenty of people. And there's other beaches, or was it just a little, like, not a cenote, but like a lake? The issue is, in Hawaii, there is no restrooms in those simple places. And then we went to a small beach, which was like hidden. We had to go like under the bushes, so to speak, walk through some kind of forest. And then we arrived. It's a small beach. We went to explore every single item we possibly could. All right, so going to see the crater is one thing. That is just a crater. It looks like a round football field. And around, surrounded by a fern forest. It's nice. Now you saw it. And then there is a real volcano. And it was actually on fire. And there are tourist guides, and they give you safety instructions, like bring a water bottle. Because it gets hot nearby. Well, not that hot, but yeah, well, just in case. There is a tremendous amount, I mean hundreds of tourists coming. And they form a line. You're just like if you've ever been to Disneyland. And you walk very slowly, as near as it is safe. And then you go back home. So that is my experience with Hawaii. Otherwise, the timeshare wasn't that cool. It has a swimming pool. It had outdoor grills shared. Anybody could use them. And the timeshare is never that new. It's kind of funny when you have timeshare like that, because they have the same dishes, the same silverware. And there is no beach. I don't remember any, because I would have gone there. So that is one thing. And what bugged me is that it's so cold. It says it was around, what, 80 degrees? Yeah, but with wind and fog. That's often beaches have fog. I have not seen fog there. Many beaches have fog. It's less than ideal. But yes, it's cold. It's like super windy and freezing. You have to have a jacket at nighttime. It was uncomfortable and unwelcoming, the beach in Hawaii. And then there is the resorts. So we took a resort, and of course it was filled, it was stuffed. And the swimming pool is not that very large. And it's kind of surrounded by, well, lots of like taller buildings, you know, the hotel, where you can have a room. But the beaches are very narrow over there. Almost impossible. It feels a little bit clamped, even in that spot, which is like deluxe. Zofia lost her favorite blanket. I kind of feel sorrowful about it. I'm not sure how that could happen because, you know, someone in the hotel took all the luggage. And because we did not really travel to go on an airplane just to, you know, from the timeshare to the hotel, we had a lot of little bags. And she had her favorite blanket. It was a baby blanket. Okay, what it was, it looked more like a pillow. It was a baby blanket with extra soft feathers. Yeah, which Olivia, the ugly Olivia, handed me down. It was a hand down. But she loved it. Yeah, that was her little Linus blanket item. She put it in a plastic bag. And as she arrived to the... It didn't arrive. And that's not professional. That's not safe. So the helicopter ride, you have to make a reservation. And yeah, we fit all in one helicopter. So 1, 2, 3, 4 plus the pilot. The pilot was old, but he looked like old American. You know, they look like hardy. Like they have been smoking a lot and drinking plenty. I wonder if it would be safe to be with the helicopter guy. And then we heard the story that you can also rent an airplane over the volcano. But then we heard the story that someone had died, and that often people die on these airplane flights. No, I did not want to take one of those, the small ones. No, thank you. When we arrived to Ilo, which is the city I showed you on at 4 o'clock, was it 3 now? I felt cold there. It was like, yeah, cold. There were like no vibration, no harmony in it. I wonder, is anybody even living here? It's kind of strange. It's not pretty. And then we made another stop in some kind of cave. Yeah, a tiny bit. It's just a little bit of a like jungle-like vibe. You park, you walk, you know, 2 steps and look, and that's it. And overall, even if there would be nature to be watched, everything in between looked kind of filthy and dirty. So this is my experience to Hawaii. Well, the question is, would I ever go back? And I tell you redundantly, no, thank you. Why would I bother? Now, my measurement is not Minneapolis. My measurement, yeah, my control group, if you want, is Mexico. The beaches in Mexico are outstanding. The tourism is outstanding, next to perfect. And had been low forever since, because it all began, I don't know, was it now the 50s or 60s, Acapulco? Everywhere. It's never cold on the beaches in Mexico. Not at daytime, not at nighttime. It is always welcoming. And then there is a few other spots tourists worth to see. Yeah, pyramids everywhere. Certain cities, colonial cities, everywhere. Everything is kept clean and neat. Mexico knows how to treat their tourists. It is absolutely amazing. I've been everywhere, pretty much. From all the way to the, we call it Southeast. Southeast in relation to the rest of Mexico, it would just be East, which is Cancun, that area, to, you know, Yucatan, to the inland, to Baja California. I have been at... Why is this so weird? I am so up to date with everything. I look at so many things, but that was a moment. I've been to Baja California and I wasn't aware. I thought we were inland. We took an airplane to Mexicali and then some chauffeur drove us to the beach. It was going through like desert. It was desertic. And the beach was impressive. It was so amazing. It seemed like I was living in a different world. I show you a picture. So this is Baja California. And the right side is the inland of Mexico. And I've been to San Felipe, which is all the way up, looking over to Sonora. The beach sand is white. The ocean is swimmable. The silence, it's amazing. Maybe I said too much. How can Mexicans feel diminished in the vision of the world, having such amazing paradise? There is no other country who has so much paradise everywhere. How can they? Well, it is because Mexicans usually don't swim. Mexicans also usually don't go to the beach unless they live around the beach. And those who go, that is very interesting. Look, if you are educated, then you go. But uneducated Mexicans don't go. But those who go, and I'm not quite sure if those I saw came from the area or were actually having a vacation. That was Acapulco, let me tell you. So Acapulco is a bahia, safe to swim. Plenty of hotels. And then there's Acapulco downtown. Okay, there's a tiny bit of access to the beach, but it's almost impossible. And there's a tiny hidden beach Gina showed me. It's not that that's cool, it's just in front of her apartment. Not touristy at all, too small. And but on the other side, there is like a very impressive resort was built and the ocean is open, so you cannot take the beach. There's a few luxurious resorts. The beach is very wide and you can have chairs. I mean, the chairs are right there from the resort. Look at the ocean, but it's not really safe to go in the ocean, which is outside the Bahia. But still in the Bahia area, there is another little thing. It's called, doesn't matter how it's called. It's a tiny Bahia. And there go the simple Mexicans. When you see any tourist vacation spot, just like in the movies, people have swimsuits on, you know, bikinis, they dive, they're, I don't know, they have lots of little things, attires. But when you go to Puerto Marquez, the Mexicans, they're all overweight. They don't go in the water precisely, they stand at the beginning of that water. They're all standing like the sardines, stacked up with their clothes on. Yes, clothes on, shirts and shorts and just standing there. And that is not very touristy. So what they do is they convert the ocean in a public toilet. It's next to disgusting, disgusting Cerrimo. What am I observing? The lack of culture? Also the lack of connection with their body. Because it is frowned upon to show the body because of the Catholic thing. These are the uneducated ones, the superstitious people. Other than Hawaii, we did drove the entire circumference of the big island. But in Mexico, I have not driven the entire circumference. But on the other hand, yeah, I pretty much did. I have been to so very many beaches on every single side of Mexico. It's safe to say I know them all. I know what the circumstances are, how they look and what the conditions are. That's what I'm saying. I can tell you, I can show you a map of Mexico, but I have been, let's say, 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, there is nothing. There's like Belize, I guess. 6 o'clock, okay, Chiapas I haven't been, but yeah, then pretty much. Or let's not say 5 o'clock is maybe Chiapas. Or maybe it's, okay, let's say I have been to 5 o'clock, I have been to 6 o'clock, I have been to 7, to 8, yeah, to 9, to 10. I have been to every single side. And the pyramids. Who visits the pyramid? Well, they are visited by tourists from outside of Mexico or by academics. Mexicans are not interested to look because they are not proud of their heritage. They are not proud of the heritage of indigenous. Indigenous in Mexico are downsized, actually. But academics don't have that issue, because the academics, they know there's the indigenous who once were here, the Aztecs, if you may, or other cultural groups. And that was then. And now is now. We are different. We are not the same. Besides, if the indigenous built the pyramids, what is there to say? What's wrong with that? The living indigenous usually don't go arse licking. They keep to themselves. In a way, the major part of the Mexican population sees their very own fermented ignorance reflected in the Indios, the indigenous. And in a projection of self-hatred, they loathe now the indigenous instead. The irony.
Je rêvais dans mon nouveau, sans excès cette fois, plus double courtois, un monde bien plus beau. Je l'ai déjà vu mille fois, mais jamais sans toi. Je rêvais dans mon nouveau, sans excès cette fois, plus double courtois. Un monde bien plus beau. Je l'ai déjà vu mille fois, mais jamais sans toi.